sounds kind of typical, but for I don't remember what birthday it was, but I was very young, 8, 9, or 10 or something like that. I got a Brownie camera, you know, the little red button and the slider clicker on it, and started taking pictures, and I always had a camera since then. The first good camera I had was a Yashica 35mm camera, film camera, and I carried that around with me probably for 10, 15 years, something like that. Ended up coming out west to Idaho, University of Idaho, and got hooked on backpacking and mountain climbing, and took always had the camera with me, and ended up studying photography at the University of Idaho for 2 years before leaving to work as a seaman up on in a research ship in Alaska. So, you know, I always had it in me to try and make a living as a photographer, and once my kids grew up and got the heck out of the house and college was all paid for, I decided to give it a go, and for the last 6 years I've been pretty much full-time doing photography. I travel a lot, and again, I look for a sense of place, a sense of images that can convey the what it's like to be there, and people are a part of that. So I have a fairly large collection of images of people from Morocco, Italy, Mexico, Cuba, among other places, and the way people dress, the way people live, I think that it's of deep interest to me, and I think it's important, especially for people in this country, to see how other people live and what they do for work, how they transport themselves, how they eat, how they entertain themselves. I have a great collection of photographs from Morocco, taken in a UNESCO World Heritage site called the Gemma al Fana. And people out there eating on the square, eating dinner at 3 o'clock in the morning and playing music till the sun comes up. They do this every night. And, you know, it's just a great thing to be able to capture images that give people the feel of what it was like to be there.